You know, the real issue in Canada now is it's not working because clearly Justin Trudeau misinterpreted his mandate. He made a promise to Canadians that he would balance the budget in 2019 and he would get millennials jobs, and he's failed on both fronts. The real scare now is people are starting to feel that deep sinking feeling that he doesn't actually know what he's doing. And that's the big problem. And so by every metric, and particularly this latest news where he's promised Canadians deficit budgets for 38 years, ending up in $1.5 trillion of deficit, that means my children are going to inherit debt that they get no benefit from. They'll spend all their tax dollars servicing debt. I'm not going to let him do that. Not a chance in hell. The key is he should have waited. I was really surprised when he didn't use the excuse of the Trump election to actually pivot. In other words, change his policy on taxation, change his policy on carbon, change his regulatory environment so that at least Canada's competitive with the United States, our biggest trading partner and largest competitor. He just marched into oblivion. He made us the most uncompetitive country in North America now, and we're in deep trouble, and it's manifesting itself in the fact we have no GDP growth. Canada does not work at 0.7% GDP growth. It needs 3. You want health care, you want education, you want military spending, you want the social net, you need 3% GDP growth. When you stall an economy because of bad bankrupt policy, you kill what Canada is to Canadians. That's why I have to go and get Trudeau on his way to his next vocation, whatever that is, because it's not running Canada.